Hey there, welcome to Life Noggin. If you go to an Amazon fulfillment center, chances are you'll probably see a robot working, picking and packing items up to make that process more efficient. This is just one example of robots doing work that a human can do. Robots can now take over assembly line jobs, clean your carpet, and even successfully get you from point A to point B with autonomous vehicles. And this causes a lot of worry among the general public that there are people going to be put out of work because of these artificially intelligent robots. So the question is, should we let them take those jobs? The short answer is yes. To start, which job do you think a robot will take over first? A doctor or a nurse? Interestingly, current work in the field of artificial intelligence seems to suggest that a doctor might be the first in line. To show why, let's talk about skin cancer. A lot of the time, this is initially detected by looking at an abnormal area on someone's skin, and then that person might get a biopsy to confirm the diagnosis. In computer science terms, this is basically an image classification task. So a team of researchers at Stanford set out to create a way to classify a variety of skin lesions and tell whether they are cancerous or not. And if so, determine if it was one of the deadliest skin cancers. They did this using something called a deep convolutional neural network, and trained it with a dataset containing about 130,000 images. And when the researchers compared the results from their artificial intelligence diagnosis algorithm to the diagnoses from 21 professional dermatologists, the AI performed just as well. Seriously, how freaking cool is that? If this was made into an app, people could get diagnosed straight from their smartphones, and it could probably save a lot of people's lives. That said, it's not like doctors are going to be out of jobs all of a sudden and vacationing all day, every day. I know, doc, it's sad, but you gotta put that inflatable flamingo down for a second. Instead, smart technology will probably be used alongside doctors in their work. So that's just one example. It's possible that as more and more companies work on autonomous vehicles, and they continue to get safer and are widely used, roads might be safer than they are now. I mean, in the US alone, 28 people die from drunk driving accidents every day. But if everyone uses autonomous vehicles, that number could theoretically shrink to zero, which is obviously a great thing. So there's clearly a lot of benefits of allowing smart technology to replace or improve some jobs. And excluding any effects this may have on the economy, it may even help with your health as well, assuming you might work a bit less if there is also a robot doing some of your work. See, research from the Australian National University found that working more than 39 hours a week can have negative health effects since you have less time to eat well and look after yourself. So in a world where robots do some of our work, people might be healthier and have more time for their hobbies, and more time to pump some iron at the gym. Yas, work it. But what do you think? Would you be okay with robots taking your job? Do you think it's a good thing or a bad thing? Let me know why in the comments section below. So we know how smart technology is, but how smart is your own body? If you're curious, you should definitely check out this video. Your brain receives signals from your body telling it how much oxygen it needs, which is why you typically breathe slower when you're relaxed than when you're running to your computer on Monday mornings to get that sweet Life Noggin knowledge. My name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin, don't forget to keep on thinking.